How can a totally depraved, powerless free will choose anything godly? If free will can only choose Christ with divine grace, then that choice is of God, not of the sinner. The Arminian God is the false Christ of Rome. He is made of metal, plastics, wood, and stone. Forever hung on a bent cross, crying, helplessly awaiting, and begging, this world's powerful walking dead, to choose him. The biblical Jesus Christ is the resurrection and the life. He walks among the dead and says, "Live." And those whom he predestined will hear him and live to eternity.
"Truly, truly, I say to you, an hour is coming and is now here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live."
Arminianism gives you total control in your salvation. If you are not stupid enough to reject God's salvation offer, you will surely get to heaven. Calvinism, on the contrary, says that you have absolutely no control in your salvation. It totally depends on God's mercy. Therefore, while Arminians feeling complacent over their wise choice, Calvinists sing this in tears. It's important to know our Creator exactly as what the Scriptures revealed, that no one should worship an unbiblical God of his own imagination. So, let's take a look at the Arminian misconceptions and compare them against the scriptures. Both Arminians and Calvinists admit the total depravity of men. The Calvinist, total depravity means total inability. Mankind is unable to choose the righteous God, Jesus Christ, because all men died in the day when Adam ate Satan's fruit. All men lost their eternal life 6,000 years ago. The Arminian, totally depraved men, however, are not dead. Therefore, their totally depraved free will can still choose Christ. Irresistible grace is Yahweh's righteous husband love for his sinful wife. Every Bible figure who refused God's calling was persuaded by God's love and righteousness to do his will, as in the cases of Moses, Gideon, Jonah, and Jeremiah. God will never abandon you or choose someone else because you refuse him. If your name is in the book of life, his love pursues you until you surrender. How sweet! How faithful! How persistent!
For those whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, in order that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those whom he predestined, he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified.
The conversion of the Apostle Paul is a sweet example of irresistible grace. I wish God had converted me like that. In my case, I struggled with God for about 15 years before I surrendered to his unyielding love. Yes, Yahweh's grace is irresistible.
The Son gives life to whom he will. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up on the last day. But there are some of you who do not believe. This is why I told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by the Father. open my eyes that I may behold wondrous things out of your law.
The biblical predestination is not predeterminism, that every detail of a person's life is predetermined by God, as that of false religions. The biblical predestination is Yahweh unconditionally chose a remnant of mankind from hell to inherit his kingdom before the foundation of the world, and wrote down their names in the book of life of the Lamb. If God had made his wife a robot by predetermining every details of her life, then his wife indeed should blame him for sin. But that's not the biblical predestination. The elect is a dead people who are given life in the Spirit and led by the Spirit in every step of their life. Like a child being led by daddy's hand, the child may still stumble when absent-minded, but he can never lose his life from such stumbling. Election is because of him who calls. Predestination is done in God's husband love for his wife. Predestination is according to the purpose of him who works all things according to the counsel of his will.
Therefore, brothers, be all the more diligent to confirm your calling and election. For if you practice these qualities, you will never fall. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory with great joy. For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to give strong support to those whose heart is blameless toward him. Gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable. And I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Jesus Christ. Not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. This people honors me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of lawlessness. They went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would have continued with us. But they went out that it might become plain that they all are not of us. This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sin. Out of the anguish of his soul he shall see and be satisfied. By his knowledge shall the righteous one, my servant, make many to be accounted righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. To you it has been given to know the secrets of the kingdom of God, but for others they are in parables, so that seeing they may not see, and hearing they may not understand. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Eyes of all look to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand, you satisfy the desire of every living thing. He makes his sun rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust. I will have mercy on whom I have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I have compassion. Jacob I loved, but Esau I hated. But Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of heaven. For we are the aroma of Christ to God among those who are being saved and among those who are perishing.
When the predestined hear the gospel, they come to eternal life. When the non-predestined hear it, they don't get it. For they are hearing someone else's love letters.